to lesson two. Very excited about this lesson because now we are going to actually identify your target market, right? How do we identify them? How do we find them, etc.? And so typically, if you're going to be building a brand around you and your goals and your passions, etc., there's really no better place to look than yourself right in the beginning. Because you are looking for other people who are going to get value from you and are going to relate with you very, very easily. So keep that in mind, right? So what does that look like? I'm going to run through just a scenario of kind of what my target market looks like, and then hopefully that'll spawn some ideas for you and yourself, and I'll throw out a few different tips along the way as well, so that we can kind of maybe dig into things deeper. But if you do have questions, you know, please feel free to ask them in the group, and we'll make sure you get those answered. We've got a lot of really smart people in there. So for myself, which, even though I don't look this old, I'm actually 29. So I'm going to throw that down as kind of like my target market age group. Obviously, I am a male. Shouldn't have to write this one up here, but, we'll go and do it anyway. Now, location could be extremely broad, such as USA, or it could be extremely narrow, such as, Georgia or California or whatever else. It just kind of depends on what your business is based around. But for myself, I'm looking for people like me all around the United States. That way I've got a bigger bucket of people to choose from that I can kind of throw through my funnel and then essentially find the winners who are actually going to go out there, do the work that it takes to become a digital nomad. So when it comes to occupation, I'm going to speak from previous experience. So previously, if you do know my story, I was in a phone sales job in the transportation industry. So I'm going to go and throw that down here. Phone sales in the transportation industry. Some people just consider that corporate America. So we'll just kind of keep it easy, right? So more dialed in when it comes to who you're going for. If you're literally trying to call out individuals who are just like you, then your information could be based around having a job in phone sales or how you used to be in the transportation industry. You want to go a little bit more broad, just talk about how you couldn't stand to be in corporate America anymore. So that way you can relate with that person who is, where you once were in your own shoes, hating the fact that you had a manager cracking a whip over your head, trying to get more dials out of you for the day, or trying to get, hit your numbers even though you already passed quota, blah, blah, blah. You really speak to those pain points, which we'll actually get into in the next lesson here. So for you, it could be anything. It could be anything from, used to work at McDonald's, and now, I'm building a business online, and now I'm on my way out of the fast food industry, etc. You could have been a dog walker. Maybe you were already an entrepreneur, had another business. Then you can speak to other people who are at that walk in life, at that place in life, in the same walk of life. Therefore, you guys can relate back and forth, and you can really just kind of hit those pain points much, much better than someone who has no experience in that industry. So, once you got your occupation down here, go ahead and start listing down those passions and hobbies. Passions for myself would be, entrepreneurship, kind of like I spoke about before. I love to travel, hence digital nomad. I love to hike, I love to camp, I love to be on the go, so we'll just say camping. And just keep these things in mind too, because later on down the line when you're providing content, you can throw some of your passions and some of your hobbies out there so that people who like the same things, they have a relating point to you. So this list can be as long as you want it to, and later on down the line when you're producing content, more is always better. So when you've got more things you can kind of draw from at any point in time, that's a very, very good thing. Because everybody kind of has those creative blocks and they just don't even know what to talk about, what to write about, etc. But they know they need to put out content because they've got hungry viewers, hungry readers, etc. ready to consume that next piece of content. Having this type of stuff written down makes that a lot easier. So, another thing I love, and definitely one of my, I'm kind of a techie, and so I love tech, love technology. So all these different things I can talk about, and then I can relate with people, when it comes to finding our target market here. So now when it comes to, our goals and desires, when I was back in corporate America, one of my biggest dreams, biggest goals, biggest desires was to live the 4-hour work week. About 9 to 12 months before I left corporate America to be a digital nomad full time, I had read a book called The 4-Hour Work Week. And so you'll probably hear me talk about that numerous times because it was seriously one of those books that just kind of unplugged me from the matrix. It made me think in a completely different way. And it really did change my life. And a lot of people say that about a lot of different things, and that was really the button for me. And so 4-hour work week, that was kind of my goal, one of my desires when I decided to pursue entrepreneurship and building a business online. So I'm gonna throw that down here. Obviously you can say that in many different ways, but since 4-hour work week kind of encompasses all of it, we're running with that. I wanted to travel more. I wanted to, explore other countries. Explore world. I wanted to, let's see here. Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, my faith is a big part of who I am. I wanted to be able to take mission trips around the world and not have to worry about the dollar bill or being able to fund it or anything like that. I wanted to be able to go and pour into these communities that didn't have water or were hard up for resources, etc., and not think about giving them what they needed in order to not just survive but ultimately thrive. And so I'm going to throw that one down here as well. Missions work. And so, like I said, those are some of my goals, desires. You can kind of speak to your audience when you know what their goals and desires are. And so whatever your audience is, right, if you're in the fitness niche, your target audience might be, I desire to lose 15 pounds, or my goal is to get into the gym more than 2 days a week, 4 days a week, 5 days a week, etc. So write those goals and desires down, because once we know them, we'll be able to call out the pain points of those individuals that you're targeting. And then you'll be able to speak to those goals and desires and letting them know that it is possible if they just, kind of follow you, your advice, and the content that you're putting out there. So lastly, where do they hang out online, right? Where are you gonna find these people? How are you gonna market to them? How are you gonna get your content and then ultimately your core offers or product in front of them? These days it's primarily social media. Some of them might hang out in forums, but for the most part, we're gonna throw down Facebook, Instagram, kind of all the standards. A lot of them hang out, try to get you advice on YouTube. Like I said, forums. So, just a few places. This is probably gonna be very similar for just about any niche or target market that you're going after, because those platforms are so used by pretty much everybody. If you have more of like a business to business type company you're running, or you're an incredible designer and you want to get your information out or your content out to someone who's a higher up in a company who makes those decisions, then maybe LinkedIn is where you want to go. But ultimately, figure out where those people are, figure out how you can jump in different groups with them, how you can get your content in front of them, because once they know, like, and trust you, they will buy from you. And this is where we're going. So appreciate it, guys. We're gonna jump over into lesson 3 here in just a bit. So I'm gonna erase this whiteboard and we'll see you on lesson 3.